What is happening, my friends? We're back again today with another Patreon request. This one is for Sufjan. Thank you very much, Sufjan. And we are checking out a little bit more Passcode. So it's not often that I can say I pulled something up on my channel and I forced my friends to listen to it immediately. But I can say that for Passcode. I made at least three people listen to them. It doesn't happen often that I do that. Four cute Japanese girls singing and screaming to J-pop, metal, and video game sounds. I mean, that's pretty much Champa Medium's life outside of the Champa Medium YouTube channel all the time for the last 35 years. If I didn't get any more requests for it, I was just going to go off on my own and do it myself anyway. All right, let's do this. This one's called Starry Sky. I already like how that started out. Just because... I'm gonna do it. Sorry. It's gonna happen. I'm starting it over. I thought the coolest... Just the thing that jumps out at you instantly is the fact that they, for this beginning intro transition thing into whatever the verse is about to be, they used each element of their sound at one time and then switched to the next one. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it started off with, like, what, slow piano, like, pop sound? Then it went to, like, one super heavy chord, one metal chord, and then right after that, it went into the video game sounds. Great way to introduce new people, right? Sounds poppy here. Bomb. Cool. It's like, here are all of our elements at once in 3 seconds. Enjoy. I actually get to see them in this video too. They were like covered up and moving a lot in the last one. Oh. Wow, they really don't stay with one sound for very long, do they? They changed the key to go into this chorus too. Don't worry, I'm gonna go back and listen to that, to the intro to that chorus again. But I just thought that it was what I'm liking so much about them so far, at least in this song. They did it a lot in the other song too, but specifically in this song, it's just that they come in with these riffs that sound like they're gonna last, like, I don't know, you know, 4 bars like normal things would. But some of these are only lasting one, a literal bar, like this. See, 1 bar. It's really just an extension on the verse. And we're in super major chords for this chorus here. Bruh, I love this sound. Like, I can't explain enough how this music is just, like, written for me. Like, straight up. And I'm not just talking about Passcode right now, either. I'm talking about a lot of the music that I've heard, a lot of the J-rock, specifically, that I've heard on my channel since I started reacting to more than just K-pop. It's just exactly what I want out of music. It's, like, heavy guitar riffs, creativity, but when push comes to shove at the end of the day, that shit's gonna make you want to bop your head. It's catchy. The choruses are always catchy, and it's just like, this is a perfect example of exactly what I want out of music, where that chorus was so happy and so bobby, and just like, I just wanted to be grooving out to it, but without the buildup of those, like, metal heavy elements before it, I would not enjoy it. I don't want to hear just catchy, you know what I mean? I need heavy and catchy to intertwine. I need them to combine to create one massive... That's a transition, man. Let's hear that one more time. Whoa. Grind metal right there. Grindcore. We got a lead riff carrying us through too. Ooh, you hear that bass right there? I also love how, like, and this just goes along with what I was saying about the catchiness and the heaviness. They're playing heavy riffs in the background, and, like, metal-sounding stuff, but the vocals during those moments are very poppy. That just works out beautifully. I think that, like, the combination is wonderful. Metal doesn't always have to be screaming, you know what I mean? And now, I want to see if they're going to do the opposite, because they have, while she's been screaming during those parts, there's been heavy metal behind her. I wonder if there's ever going to be a point where she's the screamer is screaming over, like, a poppy-sounding instrumentation. We'll see. That's cool, man. That's so cool. Just palm mutes. Keyword breath here. You hear that bass, man? Man, they have so many different sounds to work with in these transitions. Like, I never know if they're going to do a transition with a guitar, with a keyboard, with the screamer. Like, it's so different every time. And, like, it throws you off, but it doesn't feel... I don't know, man. It's keeping me interested throughout the course of the song, as opposed to me, like, you know, the predictability, like, it gets to me. Eventually, I feel that repetition. I'm just not feeling that here. It's such a fine line you have to walk when you're writing music like this, where between, like, too much chaos and too much repetition. Like, you can't be non-repetitive at all, because then it just sounds like a big mess. You have to have some sort of backbone, but if you stick to that backbone for too long, it gets boring, man. So, like, they're hitting this for me right now. They're hitting that sweet spot. It's like they sing like Perfume during these points, you know? And when you think about the kind of music that's behind it, it's just like, what? Hey, different sounds too here. That part right there was so like the end of an anime, you know? That's a legit. That keyboard is legit. Wow. So many parts. The bass too, like, can I just say that bass, man, like, it's hard not to notice it in this song. It's got sort of like a, the high end is kind of loud, like, especially for like a metal sound. Usually the bass is like a lot bassier. But you could hear that high end. It's got like a little bit of a tinniness to it. But what it does is it breaks through the keyboard sound. You know, like the keyboard always has a high end sound to it. Just that's just the nature of a keyboard. You have to get through those electronics to in order for the audience to hear it. And so they've turned up the high end, the treble on it a lot, and it's working. You can hear, but it's not even like a bit. It's more of a very like, I don't know, man. It's cool. Like you hear each individual note. They're all cute. What the hell? What a way to get in with that lead, man. This drummer, too. Can I just say that this drummer, like, almost plays... This drummer knows what he's doing in this band. Because he's playing an actual drum set, but... Every once in a while, like, when you hear those, like, heavy keyboard parts where it sounds like the song is more veering towards that video game sound, the drummer starts playing sounds that are almost like programmed drum beat sounds. Like, even just the way that he's doing this, these rolls right here sound what you would hear in an electronic drum roll as opposed to a real one. And it's definitely intentional because of the sound. Listen here. It's just very on point. It's like very exact. Brr, brr, brr. It's very exact. It's almost mimicking a computer program. You gotta be really good to mimic a computer program because they're perfect. Man, this part, it's just like full of hope too. You know what I mean? What the hell is this song about? Let's give it a like. Oh, yeah. There's so much going on. Oh, what a beautiful way to end that, too, with that just lead hanging out there. And I don't know if that's the same notes. Never mind. I'm not willing to sit through an ad. Oh, man. Dude, 2 for 2. I'm super blue right now. Okay, I'm normal human colored again. Yeah, so I just... You know, I said a lot of it inside the review, so I'm going to keep this short, but, like, I mean, they're speaking my language, man. They're speaking my musical language and my just, like, hobbies in general and the person that I am. One thing I didn't really comment is I love the combination of this. I love their usage of the scream. It's not overdone, and I think that, like, a lot of metalheads feel like there needs to be screaming in songs. I disagree with that entirely. Like, I mean, I grew up with metal, you know, in the 80s and 90s that didn't have screaming in it at all. But the way that they incorporate the screaming into this, it's just like it comes out of nowhere sometimes, but just enough to break up the monotony of the song. And then it goes away again, you know? And sometimes it's layered over the vocals too, which I think sounds really good. It's just a really perfect combination. Anyway, I'm out of here. Peace.